Dear students and my teacher friends, Namaskar. I welcome you to the presentation lecture on muscle contraction. Now here on the screen, as we can see, the girl looks very fit and fine. The reason why the girl is very fit and fine, that the reason lies in her lifestyle, okay? And see the stunt she is performing with one hand, okay? And what is her lifestyle? See, she eats balanced diet, okay, and regularly she is doing the exercise. 10 o'clock on the bed, and she woke up 5 o'clock in the morning. Within an hour she freshen up, and at 6 o'clock with the family on dining table doing the breakfast. After taking the breakfast, she goes to the gym, okay? Now girl enters into the gym, and here you can see the rack full with various dumbbell, and you cannot see the girl, okay? Because right now the girl has entered in the gym and she has started to perform the stretching and warm up exercise. That's why we cannot see the girl. Okay, now here she is. And today is the Tuesday, and on Tuesday this girl performs the she is doing the arm exercise on Tuesday. So the arm exercise means the shoulder exercise and the bicep exercise on Tuesday she used to perform on Tuesday. Now she is thinking, which exercise to start with, and she has decided to do the dumbbell raise exercise. So today she is going to perform 4 sets of dumbbell raise and 12 counts, okay? So she has started, and now here she is doing the dumbbell raise exercise, okay? As you can see, she has raised the dumbbell. And now one question will come in your mind, that all the girls are different, this is not the same girl that you have seen in the first photograph, okay? So all the girls are different. So for that, I would like to tell you that nowadays many girls are health conscious, okay, and they are living the healthy life, and that's why these are the different girls, okay? So as you can see, she has started her exercise. Now when she is holding the dumbbell in her hand, and when she start, okay, what happens, which are the events that are taking place? So now see over here, see events at the neuromuscular junction, okay? So let's say this is her hand, okay, and in the hand muscle or the arm muscle, what are the changes that are taking place? So she has decided, as she has decided to dumbbell, to perform the dumbbell raise exercise, so from her brain, a nerve impulse first propagate to spinal cord, and from spinal cord the spinal nerve is entering into her hand, okay? And this is the muscle cell of her hand, and this is the nerve impulse. This is the nerve impulse or the action potential. So now what are the changes? So see, the nerve is joining the muscle cell. That junction is known as neuromuscular junction, okay? So here this is the myelinated axon or motor neuron, and with the pink color, action potential is shown. Okay, so here you see axon terminal of neuromuscular junction. Okay, and this is the sarcolemma of muscle fiber. Okay, so skeletal muscle cell, muscle fiber, and cell membrane of muscle fiber is known as sarcolemma. So now what is happening? See, at neuromuscular junction, what happened? Nerve impulse reaches to neuromuscular junction, acetylcholine is released, and this acetylcholine, upon binding, this ACH binds to receptors, and these receptors are present in sarcolemma. So this ACH causes change in sarcolemma's permeability, and as the permeability of the sarcolemma change, leading to change in membrane potential. Okay, so one by one we are discussing all this event. Now this portion, this region, so axon terminal yellow color, then this is the this zigzag line that you are looking at is the sarcolemma. Now what are the changes are taking place, what are the events at neuromuscular junction? So in this figure also, this one is the axon terminal. Axon potential arrives at axon terminal of motor neuron. So with the pink curve arrow, they have shown that axon potential has arrived to axon terminal. Now what happened? As axon potential arrive to axon terminal, see, this is the membrane of axon terminal, and in the membrane calcium channels are present. So these channels are voltage gated C8+ channel. Okay, and due to, as the axon potential has arrived, these channels are now open. So channels are open, so C8+ ions, they enter into the axon terminal. Okay, they are entering into axon terminal. Now once the C8+ enter into axon terminal, then what happened? See, in the axon terminal, synaptic vesicles are present. Okay, and in this synaptic vesicle, ACH is present. Synaptic vesicles are filled with ACH neurotransmitter, acetylcholine. Now due to the entry of C8+, this entry of C8+ causes the exocytosis of this synaptic vesicle. So here now you can see, and in exocytosis, what is happening? Synaptic vesicle are bursting. So here you can see synaptic vesicle is burst, and as the synaptic vesicle burst, this acetylcholine, which are shown green in color, they are coming out. Okay, and where these acetylcholine molecules are going? So this is the sarcolemma. Okay, and in the sarcolemma, these are the receptor molecule. Okay, so now the ACH bind with this receptor molecule. See, so on the fourth point, ACH diffuses across synaptic cleft and binds to its receptor on the sarcolemma. Okay, so here you can see acetylcholine binds to receptor. Now what happened? See, on the fifth point, as ACH bind to receptor, so this receptor also acting as ion channel. So ACH, as ACH is binding to this receptor, what is happening? Ion channel is open now. So from outside, Na plus is entering into the cytosol of the muscle fiber, and from the cytosol K plus is moving out. Okay. So and as the ions are exchanged, then what happened? So the function, the role of ACH is completed. So now the ACH needed to be degraded, and who is degrading this ACH? So see, enzyme acetyl choline esterase. So this is the acetyl choline esterase, and you can see that once the ion exchange completed, Na plus inside, K plus outside, in the synaptic cleft, what is happening? ACH is degraded by acetylcholine esterase enzyme, and here you can see degraded ACH. So who is degrading? So we are remembering the name of enzyme, acetylcholine esterase. And now since the ACH is degraded, so now ion channel closes, ions cannot pass. Okay, so I'm showing you this entire figure, so you go through this figure. Okay, now this point, okay, see, N plate potential, generation of N plate potential. Now what is this N plate potential? See, you can read this information. I am directly explaining you what is this N plate potential. See, here before ACH came, this is the sarcolemma. Okay, now we know Na plus were present outside. Okay, here there were Na plus, so due to that, as Na plus are outside, what happened here there was positive charge earlier, okay, and inside there was a negative charge. Okay, but now as you can see, now ACH binds to receptor, so this ion channel open. So now what happened? Na plus from outside enters into cytosol, and this process, entry of Na plus, is very quick. So many Na plus quickly enters into the cytosol, and this is followed by exit of K plus, but the exit of K plus from cytosol to outside is slower reaction. So now what happens? As the Na plus enter in the cytoplasm, so the outside of the sarcolemma, this side becomes negative, and now the Na plus are in the cytoplasm, so inside there is positive charge develop. Okay, so this change, okay, this change is known as N plate potential. Okay, so we can say the sarcolemma sarcolemma is depolarized. Okay, sarcolemma becomes less negative. Okay, see, a transient change in membrane potential occurs as the interior of the sarcolemma becomes less negative. Less negative means interior becomes positive because Na plus has entered into the cytoplasm. Okay, so the initial depolarization is local event that is known as N plate potential. Okay, so here you imagine here initially there is a positive, here there is a positive, okay, and here there is a negative, okay. But due to, now what happened here, what is happening, N plate potential, so now this depolarization is propagating. Okay, so this depolarization means negative outside, positive inside. So this wave of depolarization is known as action potential. So as the wave of depolarization is reaching over here, okay, now what happened, now this channels are going to open. So which are this channel? So see, due to depolarization, okay, see, this was the original state, outside positive charge, inside negative, but due to acetylcholine, okay, channel open, okay, this receptor or the ion channel open, Na plus entry, okay, due to that outside negative charge develop, and this negative charge is affecting the neighboring region, so the neighboring region also becomes negative and inside positive. That is called wave of polarization, and that wave of polarization is propagating. Okay, so due to that, what is happening, so this wave of depolarization, when it reach to this, so this Na plus channel, see, depolarization, how it is affecting, so generating and propagating an action potential. So as you can see, the minus Na plus, here there is a minus charge, here there is a positive, so the channel is open now, okay, due to the depolarization. Okay, so this Na plus, they are entering inside, okay, and they are entering very quickly in large number. So due to that, inside positive charge has developed. Earlier it was negative charge, but now as the Na plus is entering, the charge, positive charge, is building up. Okay, so this is called depolarization, and now the repolarization need to be performed. And how repolarization is going to achieve? So repolarization means original state, outside we require positive ion and inside we require negative charge. So see, so repolarization is achieved by this K plus channel. So now for repolarization, how to restore the original state, how to repolarize the membrane? So now to repolarize this K plus, which are present in cytosol, they are going out. Okay, so as the K plus, now they are going out, again there will be positive charge, there will be positive charge outside and then inside negative charge. Okay, so this depolarization is propagating to the entire length of sarcolemma, and this propagation of depolarization is known as action potential. Okay, so you go through this information. Okay. depolarization. Okay, this is the repolarization. Okay, and this figure, depolarization. Okay, see the direction, action potential, then repolarization. Okay, repolarization. Na plus channel close, K plus channel open, K plus going outside, so repolarization. Okay, now see excitation, contraction, coupling. Okay, now what is excitation, contraction, coupling? So excitation, contraction, coupling is the sequence of event by which transmission of an action potential along the sarcolemma leads to the sliding of myofilament, actin and myosin. Okay, so see, setting the stage. Okay, see, the events at neuromuscular junction that we have discussed, set the we have already discussed this thing, which are the event. Okay, depolarization, repolarization, everything. Okay, so these events at neuromuscular junction, they set the stage for EC coupling, providing excitation. Now release acetylcholine, bind to receptor protein on the sarcolemma, and triggers an action potential in muscle fiber. So you see, we have already discussed this thing. Okay, and this excitation, contraction, coupling, what is happening? See, now here the action potential is generated, and the wave of depolarization, repolarization is propagating. So this action potential is actually depolarization, wave of depolarization, repolarization. Okay, the potential of membrane changes, then it is restored to normal, then chain normal, and that way the action potential propagate. Now where this action potential is entering now? So here you see it is entering into T tubule. Now what is this? Okay, so here, up to here we have reached at this point. Okay, and this you can see the muscle fiber, muscle cell is shown, sarcolemma. Okay, and this one is the sarcoplasmic reticulum, endoplasmic reticulum of muscle cell, known as sarcoplasmic reticulum. And the end part, okay, so terminal cisternae are shown. Okay, and what is triad? So where that also we are discussing. Okay, so first you go through this figure. Okay. Now we are discussing the EC, excitation, contraction, coupling. Okay, steps of EC coupling. Step number one, action potential propagate along the sarcolemma and down the T tubule. So with the pink color arrow, you can see action potential is entering into T tubule. And what is T tubule? See, this one is the sarcolemma. This is the sarcolemma. Okay, and this sarcolemma invaginate inside. Okay, it is coming inside. Okay, so this invagination of sarcolemma is known as T tubule. Okay, then this is the muscle cell, and in the muscle cell, that is the muscle fiber, this is the SR, sarcoplasmic reticulum they are showing. And this part of sarcoplasmic reticulum, this part is the terminal cisternae. This one over here is also terminal cisternae. So all three together, this one terminal cisternae, this one terminal cisternae, okay, and this one in between T tubule. So all these three together, terminal cisternae, T tubule, terminal cisternae, together These three are known as triad. They are known as triad. Okay. So now, as the action potential reach to T-tubule, now what is happening? See, point number two, calcium ions are released. See, where are the calcium ions? So calcium ion, right now they are present. Where they are present? So with the red dot, they have shown the calcium ion, and they are in the terminal cistern. Okay. And why these calcium ions are releasing? What is the reason? So transmission of action potential along the T-tubule of the triad causes the voltage sensitive tubule protein to change shape. And this shape change open the C8Y+. Okay. And this C8Y+, they enter into the cytosol of the muscle cell. So here you can see that what is happening. See, okay, this one they are showing the voltage sensitive tubule protein, and this voltage sensitive tubule protein is connected with the calcium ion channel. Okay. And where these channels are present? These channels are present in the terminal cistern membrane. So now what is happening? Due to the action potential, okay, the shape of this ion channel protein is changing. So now what is happening? Calcium, so these channels are open, and you can see from the terminal cistern calcium ions are coming out. Okay, so calcium ions are released, and this calcium ion, where they are entering? So calcium ion, they enter into the cytosol. Okay, so see, once again you can read this. Okay, calcium ion, how calcium ions are released? Transmission of the AP along the T-tubule of the triad causes the voltage sensitive tubule protein to change shape. This change shape open the C8Y+ channel. Okay, channel in the terminal cistern. Okay, so this C8Y+ is now entering into the cytosol. Now what C8Y+ is doing? So here you can see the thick filament. Okay, is shown. Thick filament, we know, made up of myosin, and thin filament made up of actin. Okay, and this is the myosin head. Okay, so during resting period, this actin, see the active site. Okay, let me show you the active site of actin molecule is covered by tropomyosin. Okay, and with tropomyosin, this is the troponin. Okay, and you can see during resting period, there is no attachment of myosin with actin. They are not attached. Actin and myosin, they are separate one. Okay, but as the girl has decided to do the exercise, as the girl is raising the dumbbell, that time what is happening? Due to the propagation of action potential, okay, and calcium entered into cytoplasm, now what is happening? This calcium binds with troponin. Okay, and as the calcium bind with troponin, this troponin moves tropomyosin away from this actin's active site. So now actins active sites are open. Okay, actins active sites are open now. So they are ready to bind with myosin molecule. Okay, now let me show you this figure. Now, before we proceed, now I would like to show you, this is the thick filament in the center, okay, and thick filament we know are made up of myosin molecule. So here they are showing one myosin molecule, and this is the head of myosin molecule, and in that you can see in the head ATP binding site is present and actin binding site also present, okay. And during, this is the resting period time. So during resting, as you can see, tropomyosin is covering the myosin binding site on actin molecules, okay. Now when girl is doing exercise, okay, that means the muscle contraction is starting. So now what is going to happen? See, here this is the relaxed state they are showing. Okay, you see the sarcomere there, then you see the length of A band, I band, okay, then the partial contracted muscle they have shown, and maximally contracted muscle they are showing. Okay, okay, now when the girl is doing the exercise, that time what is happening? Okay, now this, you see, first what is happening, ATP binds with ATP binding site on myosin molecule. ATP is converted into ADP NP. So this way ATP has provided energy to myosin molecule. Okay, so as now the myosin molecule is energized, okay, so and you see the angle of myosin molecule with the rest of the myosin molecule is 90 degree. So this is called the cock position. Let me show you over here. See, cocking of myosin, okay, ATP joins with myosin molecule, ATP joins with the ATPase enzyme, okay, ATP binding site, there it is binding ATP is hydrolyzed into ADP and PI. So the energized head, okay, and it is oriented, this myosin head is oriented towards the actin. So this position of myosin head toward the actin is known as the cocking of the myosin head. Okay, so here you see the 90 degree. Okay, first now the myosin head is energized. Now what happened? So this is the first point, okay, myosin ATP hydrolyze, ATP hydrolyze, myosin head energized. Now point number two, okay, myosin head binds with the actin binding site, okay. So this, when myosin joins with, when myosin bind with actin, that is known as cross bridge formation. And here you can see ADP and P are still attached with myosin head. Okay, now from myosin head, phosphate P is released. Now what is happening? So now this myosin head Since this myosin head is energized, what this myosin head is doing? So see, myosin head is attached with actin binding side, and this myosin head is pulling the thin filament past the thick filament toward the center of the sarcomere. So what is the meaning of this? Myosin head, earlier it was 90 degree, now it has bent to, it is forming the angle of 45 degree, and this myosin head pivots, means it is bending 45 degree, and it is pulling all this thin actin filament toward the center of sarcomere. Okay, and here it is not the single myosin molecule is doing this thing. See, this is the normal condition where relaxed muscle, so myosin head is not going to join with actin binding site. But as the girl start the exercise, what is happening? See, this is partially contracted muscle, and this is the point where she has maximally uplifted the dumbbell. So her muscle of her arm are fully contracted. So now what is happening during contraction? See, over here all the myosin, they are pushing. See over here, see, this is the relaxed muscle, okay, and when she is raising the dumbbell, what happened? This myosin head, for example, let's understand with this, okay, this will pulling this side, okay, this myosin pulling this side, then another myosin joined with actin pulling this way, okay, this myosin pulling this way, then this will come over here, so they are pulling, okay, so here also myosin head pulling, myosin head joining, binding, pulling, myosin head pulling. So actin, see, yellow color actin, what is happening? They all myosin head, they are joining and they are pulling. So this actin filament coming closer to M line, okay. So here you see during contraction, okay, this actin, they reach to the level of M line, okay. So this is fully contraction. Now the girl is bringing the dumbbell into normal position, okay. So now when she is bringing the dumbbell down, that time what will happen? That time the muscle is going to relax again. So during relaxation, what is going to happen during relaxation? This head, okay, with this head again the ATP is going to join, okay, and this ATP is giving the energy, okay, and this head is going to detach from the actin, okay. So this head is now detached from the actin, and calcium ion, they are again going back to the sarcoplasmic reticulum. And now when the girl is going to, again when she is going to raise the dumbbell, okay, that time the cycle is repeated, okay. So I would like to show you some information. For example, this information you can read, okay, this information, this is the contraction cycle, okay, all the step, ATP hydrolyze, attachment of myosin to actin, power stroke, okay, detachment of myosin from actin, okay, then this improves, then this improves. Yeah, than this information. Okay.
Huh.
So with this, we have completed this presentation lecture on muscle contraction. I hope you have enjoyed this presentation lecture, and I also hope that this presentation lecture will be helpful in your exam preparation and also in your studies. My name is Manish Kochisar. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Bye-bye. Namaste.